The Higgs boson, often referred to as the God particle, plays a crucial role in giving mass to the fundamental particles in the universe. When it was discovered in 2012, it filled a missing piece of the standard model of particle physics. But new research suggests it could also be tied to the universe's potential demise. A possible trigger might be primordial black holes, the ones that formed just after the Big Bang. Unlike the massive black holes we think of today, these primordial versions could be tiny, perhaps no bigger than a gram, but they had the potential to create the exact conditions needed to disrupt the Higgs field. And yet, this hasn't happened, at least not yet. So why not? Could there be entirely new particles or forces that shield us from these cosmic disruptions? Let's take a closer look. In particle physics, the Higgs boson is like the signal that proves the existence of the Higgs field, which is present everywhere in the universe. Imagine the Higgs field as a water bath that all particles must swim through, and their interactions with it determine their mass. Some particles glide through the Higgs field effortlessly, like a fish darting through water. These are particles like photons, which make up light, and because they don't interact with the field, they remain massless and travel at the speed of light. Other particles, however, move through the field with greater resistance, like trying to swim through thick syrup. The more a particle interacts with the Higgs field, the more resistance it encounters, and this resistance is what we perceive as mass. For example, electrons interact with the field more than photons, which is why they have mass, but they don't interact as much as quarks, which is why quarks are even heavier. This water bath is crucial because it determines how particles behave and interact with one another. Without it, particles would have no mass, and the universe as we know it wouldn't exist. Particles would zip around at light speed, unable to form atoms, meaning there would be no stars, no planets, and no life. The stability of the Higgs field is essential for the universe's survival. If the Higgs field were to suddenly shift or collapse, it could cause catastrophic changes in the laws of physics. The masses of particles could shift, changing the forces that hold atoms and molecules together. This could result in the destruction of everything we know, from galaxies to subatomic particles. So, in a way, the Higgs boson's discovery helps confirm that this crucial water bath is stable, ensuring that the universe remains intact. But you might be thinking, what could possibly go wrong? Let's go back to the water bath analogy. As you know, water can exist in three states depending on temperature and pressure: solid, liquid, and gas. And it changes between these states through a process called phase transitions. What's happening on a molecular level, for example, is that the water molecules, once loosely bonded in the liquid state, gain enough energy to break those bonds and escape into the air as vapor. But phase transitions aren't limited to water. In fact, they're a fundamental concept in physics and apply to much more than just heat and matter, including the Higgs field. Right now, the Higgs field is in a stable state, just like water at room temperature. But if the Higgs field underwent a phase transition, like water boiling and turning into vapor, the laws of physics could be completely altered, leading to the disintegration of matter. Therefore, scientists are concerned about the possibility of another phase transition in the Higgs field, particularly because theoretical models suggest that our universe might be in a metastable state. This means that, while the Higgs field is stable right now at a specific energy level, it's possible that some event in the distant future could cause it to undergo another phase transition, dropping into a lower energy level. This is called a false vacuum decay, or a catastrophic phase transition. If this were to happen, it would start with a bubble of this new, lower energy vacuum forming somewhere in the universe. Once formed, this bubble would expand at nearly the speed of light, devouring everything in its path. Imagine this like a shockwave that fundamentally changes the nature of reality as it spreads. Inside this bubble, fundamental particles like quarks, electrons, and photons would no longer behave the way they do now. The forces that hold atoms together might weaken or become too strong, tearing apart the very fabric of matter. It would be like watching a stone crumble into dust, but on an atomic level. Everything would disintegrate. This is the ultimate cosmic disaster scenario. And yet, we're still here. Despite all the theorizing about this catastrophic phase transition, the universe has remained stable. So, What's holding it all together? Why hasn't the universe already ended? According to a recent study by Lucien Hertier and colleagues, one potential trigger for such a phase transition could be primordial black holes. Unlike black holes we observe today, which are created when massive stars collapse, primordial black holes could have emerged from the collapse of extremely dense regions of space-time in the early universe. These black holes could be tiny, some even as light as a gram. One key characteristic of black holes is that they can evaporate over time through a process known as Hawking radiation. Stephen Hawking proposed that black holes emit radiation from their event horizons, causing them to slowly lose mass and eventually evaporate completely. Lighter black holes evaporate faster than heavier ones, meaning primordial black holes, if they were small enough, might have already disappeared. The authors of the study suggest that these evaporating primordial black holes would have created local disturbances in the Higgs field. In other words, they would have acted like seeds for the dangerous bubbles of false vacuum we discussed earlier. The energy released by these black holes would have nudged the Higgs field, triggering phase transitions in small, localized regions. If enough of these black holes existed, or if they evaporated in the wrong place at the wrong time, it could have set off a chain reaction, creating bubbles of true vacuum that would expand and engulf the universe. But this hasn't happened, or at least, it hasn't happened yet. So why not? The authors of the research suggest that primordial black holes may never have existed at all, and recommend dismissing cosmological theories that predict their existence. However, there's room for an exciting possibility. If evidence of primordial black holes is found, it could point to new physics, such as unknown particles or forces that protect the Higgs field from bubbling, even in the presence of these black holes. In any case, the message is clear. There is still much to learn about the universe, both at the largest and smallest scales.